2017 question paper for 6 marks. Just I'll read out the question. From the following figures, prepare cost sheet showing the cost per unit and profit for the period. Raw material consumed 40,000, direct wages 24,000, factory overheads 8,000, office overhead 10% of factory cost, selling overhead is 1.50 rupee per unit, units produced 2,000 units, units sold 1,800 units at rupees 50 each. Guys, once if you read this question, he is asked us to prepare cost sheet. So I am preparing cost sheet for here. First, what he is given is raw material consumed. See, first we will take raw material consumed. What is the total raw material consumed is 40,000 rupees. First, let us calculate total cost, then we will go to the cost per unit. Okay. To this, we should add direct material. If you add direct material, 24,000, you get freight cost. Right, guys? Yes. How much you get is 64,000. So this, what is to be added is factory overhead. What is the factory overheads or factory expenses is given is 8,000 rupees, and you get 72,000 rupees as factory cost. Factory cost. To this factory cost, we should add administration or office overhead. We have to add. See, what is given is office overhead 10% of factory cost. Means your office overhead is 10% on factory cost. So 10% on factory cost. So your factory cost is 72,000, 10% of that is 7,200 rupees. Now you get cost of production. Right? What is your cost of production is 79,200 rupees is your cost of production. Now the question is, we have to add opening stock of finished goods. Does it given the opening stock of finished goods? He is not given the opening stock of finished goods. Now we get 79,200 only. So this deduct closing stock of finished goods. Does he given the closing stock of finished goods? He is not given the closing stock of finished goods. But we have to find out, because there is a closing stock of finished goods but which we don't know. How I am telling is, see, number of units, if you read the last paragraph, units produced was 2000 units. How many units was produced? 2000 units were produced. When number of units produced is 2000 and number of units sold is 1800 units, then you have 200 units of closing stock. Am I right? See, this is what the hidden adjustment in this. See, when you don't know the finished goods, please check in the problem. Does he given the number of units produced, the number of units sold? Both is given. Number of units produced is 2000, number of units sold is 1800, and 200 units of closing stock of finished goods is there. Now we need to find out what is the value of 200 units of closing stock of finished goods. If we want to come to this position, this point, now we have to calculate what is the cost per unit. See, 40,000 is for 2000 units. Per unit, it will be 20 rupees per unit. 24,000 for 2000, it will be 12 rupees per unit. Okay, now this will be 32 rupees. 8,000 is the factory overhead. For 2,000 units, it will be 4 rupees per unit. this will become 36 rupees per unit. Now, factory overhead is administration overhead 7200. For 2000 units per unit, it will be 7200 divided by 2000 units. It is 3 rupees 60 paise. Now, if you add this, 39 rupees 60 paise. Now, what is the cost of production per unit is 39 rupees 60 paise. And there is no opening stock of finished goods. Now, on what basis we calculate this 200 units of closing stock? 200 units of closing stock. We need a value. We need a value here because we have to deduct it. Now, 200 units of closing stock we take at the cost of production per unit is 39 rupees 60 paise. So, thereby 200 into 39.6 is 7920 rupees will be our closing stock of finished goods. Guys, all of you getting it? Now, please don't calculate per units here. Now, if you deduct it, how much you get is 71,280. This will be your cost of goods sold. Cost of goods sold. Now, does he give us any other information? Selling overheads is 1 rupee 50 paise per unit. See, we have to add selling and distribution overhead here. See, how many units we sold? See, this is units produced, units sold. So, how many units we sold? 1800 units we sold. What is the selling expenses per unit is 1 rupee 50 paise. So, therefore, 1800 into 1 rupee 50 paise. 1 rupee 50 paise. How much we get is? So, 1800 into 1 rupee 50 paise is 2700. Now, cost of goods sold per unit, how do you calculate, is 71,280 divided by 1,800 units, 39 rupees 60 paisa. This is 1 rupee 50 paisa and this is your total cost. Now, your total cost is 983,980. This is 41 rupees 10 paisa. And we have to find out the profit. How do you find out the profit? How do you find out the profit? Here, your total cost, I will write here, your total cost is 73,980 and 41 rupees 10 paise is per unit. We have to add what profit we have to add. So profit, how do you calculate profit? We don't know profit. How much is the profit? But we don't know what, we know what is the sales. See, totally we sold 1,800 units at what is the price per unit we sold is given in the question 50 rupees. So, 50 rupees. So, that means 50 rupees is your selling price. So, per profit per unit will be. So, 1 minute, 10, 1 carries 2 plus 8. 8 rupees 90 paise will be our profit per unit. Now, we will find out 1800 into 50 is 90,000 rupees. So, ₹16,020 is your profit. This will be your balancing figure. See guys, when you are calculating this, what is very important for us is, see, till the cost of production, we take number of units sold. After cost of production, we try to calculate per unit on number of units sold. That's all. Okay, so from here we have calculated, from cost of goods sold we have calculated per unit taking the number of units sold. say how we got this number is divided by 1800. So 71280 divided by 1800 we got it. And selling expenses is given 1 rupee 50 paise per unit sold. So number of units sold is 1800. We got it. Got it? So this will be a total cost. Once if we get your total cost to add profit. So profit is not given, but selling price is 50 rupees. Number of units sold is 1800. We got a sale of 90,000. Got a profit of 16,020. So 90,000 divided by 1800 or per unit is given. Per unit minus cost per unit. Total cost per unit will be 8 rupees 90 paise. Profit. Okay. Thank you.